a listen, too late for the learning. Made of sand, made of sand. In a wink of an eye, my soul is turning in your hand, in your hand. Are you going away with no words of farewell? Will there be not a trace left behind? I could have loved you better, didn't mean to be unkind. You know that was the last thing on. Got reasons aplenty for going. This I know, this I know. For the weeks have been steadily growing. Please don't go, please don't go. Are you going away with no words of farewell? Will there be not a trace left behind? I could have loved you better, didn't mean to be unkind. You know that was the last thing. As I lie in my bed in the morning, without you, without you. Each song in my breast as a bonus, without you, without you. Are you going away with no words of farewell? Will there be not a trace left behind? I could have loved you better, didn't mean to be unkind. I know that was the last thing on my mind. You know that was the last thing on my mind.
Well, hi there, pluckers. I was Sawfingers again with another classic for you from Tom Paxton, covered by various other artists, but originally written and sung by Tom Paxton. And the song's called The Last Thing on My Mind. I'm doing it in the same key as the original Tom Paxton recordings, where his standard tuning but capoed at the first fret. Okay. So it starts off with this little intro. It's basically a three chord trick, really, but it's normally finger picked, doing the Travis type picking, but this is for all you strummers out there. Okay. So sorry for anybody who's offended by me doing it with a pick, but there are people out there that like to play with a pick. Okay, so let's get to it. So starts off with this a little lead up, second on the fifth to the third on the fifth, open fourth, okay, and then you start a strum a G chord, okay, so. A lot of this song is based on a G chord, and then you make it a sort of C A minor seventh type shape, keeping these two where they are, third fret, bottom E string, top E string, third fret, okay? But from the G, you put these two into a C shape, first finger, second string, B string, first fret, first finger. And then this second finger goes to the second fret on the fourth. But you keep the bottom E string on the third fret, okay? Hit the bottom E string, right? That sort of thing, okay? So that's quite a lot of the song is played with those two chords, okay? So it starts off, like I said, with the intro, with this little lead up, second on the fifth, third on the fifth, open fourth, G chord strum. And then you hammer into that sort of C with G in the bass. Okay? Got that? And then you hit that open third string, okay? And then you go two lots of G there, open, and then second on the fourth, open fourth. So it's it's some more strumming on the G. Okay? Right, so. Then what you do is you hammer from the second on the, from your G shape, from the fifth string, second fret, you hammer up to the third fret and go back to the second fret. And then strum down from, with the still holding partial G chord, second on the fifth, third fret on the top E string. Okay, so far. And finally, a D with F sharp in the bass. So you can either play a D chord with thumb over, back to the G. So you've got to get that into it. Okay? But what I do is that. I play a first finger, second on the bottom E string, second finger, second on the third, and either your pinky or your third finger on the third fret as a B string, and just go from 6 down to 2. Okay? And then back to the G, okay? So it's. Okay, so very slowly, the whole intro. It's the hardest part of the song, really. Okay, here we go. That, hit the bottom E string first on the second fret, then strum the chord D, and then back to the G. Now we're into the song. Okay, so once more, very slowly. Okay, into the song. It's a lesson to the. There's those two chords I was telling you about. G, and then like a C with G in the bass. You need to make that, those two fingers look like an A minor 7th shape. First on the second, second on the fourth, okay? Keeping these two where they are, okay? Third fret bottom E string, third fret top E string, okay? So, it's a lesson to lead. Back to G. Made of sand is that C with G in the bass again. Made of, back to G, sand. Then this D chord again with F sharp in the bass. Made of sand, back to G. And then it repeats the whole thing for the next two lines, okay? So it's a lesson to late for learning. Made of sand, made of sand. Repeat the whole thing. In the wink of an eye, the soul is turning. In your hand, in your hand. Okay? And the chorus, very simple. Straight into a D chord. Okay? Are you going away? C. I'm playing a four-fingered C here. You can play a three-fingered C, that's fine. Or you can play C with G in the bass. Move this third finger up to the bottom E string, third fret. Pinky goes on to the third fret of the fifth string. You get all six strings then, it's probably a better sound for this particular thing, okay? So, from the beginning of the chorus, R, U, D, going away with no C, words of felt G, felt there. Now this, again, with this G, C with G in the bass again. B, da, back to G, trace, left, B, D. Repeat the whole thing. G, could I love you? Now, no, we did. Don't repeat. Sorry, forget that. Don't repeat the whole thing. Back to G. Could I love you? Back to this G with C with G in the bass. But I've bidden. Back to G. Be unkind. D. No, that was the last thing on my G mind. Into another verse, another chorus, another verse, another chorus. If you like, you can stick an intro in there as an instrumental. Okay, So let's just go through this chorus again, coming out in my hand. Chorus. Are you going away? C with a G. C with G in the bass. G, da, da, D. G. C with G in the bass. Back to G. D. You know that was the last thing on G. Reasons are plenty for going. This I know, this I know. For the weeds have gained steadily growing. Please don't go, please don't go. Are you going away with no words of farewell? Will there be not a trace left behind? I could have loved you better, but I'd need to be unkind. You know that was the last thing on my mind. Finish it on the intro as well if you like. It's quite universal. Thanks very much for watching. I hope that helped you out, and again apologies for anybody that likes finger picking that number, but there are a few of us around that like strumming. So see you in the next lesson. Bye.